Hello, everyone. My name is Jeremy Burr. I'm a streaming specialist solutions architect at Amazon Web Services. Today on Analytics in 15, we're covering event detection with Amazon MSK and Kinesis Data Analytics. In this presentation today, we're going to be talking about the challenge at hand. And we're going to take a look at a use case that involves gaming data, and we'll get into that in a little bit. We'll take a look at the architecture of this solution, an overview of the components that make up the solution, and finally, I'll give a demo of the end-to-end pipeline working in AWS. So what are we doing today? Well, essentially, this presentation was originally developed for AWS reInvent, and that conference at the end of every year takes place in Las Vegas. So when this was originally developed, we thought it would be a good topical presentation to cover gaming establishments that you might find in Las Vegas. So gaming establishments like to offer incentives to their frequent customers to stay in their casinos and even catch people who might be cheating at their table games. So how can we perform analysis on this near real-time data to find who the casino wants to incentivize to stay in their casinos with a free meal or a free room? And how can we use that same data to identify cheaters? And generally, we want to keep things lucrative and keep things going at the casino with things running smoothly. So how do we know when a table might need additional chips or more coins in the machines? How are we going to achieve this? Well, we will use streaming analytics with Kinesis Data Analytics Studio using events that are being created in Apache Kafka running on our managed streaming for Apache Kafka service, MSK. We'll mainly be looking at some Calcite SQL statements and a little bit of Python as well. There's much more to this workshop that we're going to be skipping over for this presentation. But if you are interested, we'll leave a link at the end so you can explore the other integrations such as Lambda, SNS, Amazon S3, Athena. All of those are available to see how they work with Kinesis Data Analytics Studio and MSK if you are interested. So just a bit about the solution overview components. MSK, or Amazon MSK, is a fully managed, highly available, and secure service for Apache Kafka. It comes in two flavors: provisioned, meaning you choose the number of brokers or machines, and you basically configure your Kafka cluster how you want it. You can also choose MSK serverless, which scales with your throughput, and you do not have to worry about rescaling or sizing your Kafka cluster appropriately. MSK comes with multiple authentication options, including SSL Scram, Mutual TLS, and IAM authentication. You can also check out our MSK Connect service, which is managed Kafka Connect, to support easy integrations with other data sources and destinations, not limited to those within AWS. Amazon Kinesis Data Analytics Studio is a fully managed serverless service provided by Apache Flink and powered by Apache Zeppelin. So this is essentially a Zeppelin notebook-based experience for visualizing analytics data in real time. If you're familiar with Zeppelin notebooks or Jupyter notebooks, this should feel very familiar to you. You can perform filtering, transformations, aggregations, all from within a SQL-based interface. And you can also use Apache Kafka or MSK connectors, as well as Kinesis Data Streams connectors natively as sources and sinks. So here's the architecture that we are talking about today. We have the casino data on the left-hand side of this presentation, producing data through some IoT sensors into an MSK cluster. We're going to be looking at the topics that are using this data and read those in through our Kinesis Data Analytics Studio application. That Studio application integrates seamlessly with our Glue data catalog to keep track of the schemas and the tables that you generate within Kinesis Data Analytics Studio. Within that application, we're going to be doing some analytics, some visualizing the data, some investigation of data, and we will eventually write some aggregate data out to our MSK topic. That data will then be picked up by a Lambda event source mapping, where it can then be used to trigger an alert, such as an email or a text message, whenever a customer may need an incentive or a free room. So that's the architecture that we're looking at today. All right, we're ready to jump into the demo now. So we're going to jump over to the AWS Management Console. Okay, so here we are at the AWS Management Console. I'm simply going to navigate to the search bar and enter Kinesis Data Analytics. There you'll find the Kinesis Analytics service link, and then we can navigate to our Studio tab, where we will find our Casino Analytics Studio Notebook name. Now, this is Kinesis Data Analytics Studio, and it's really just the management console for this service. You can see the Glue database that it's using, the IAM role, all of the nice configurations that you can set with this Studio Notebook. But the main interaction is going to be once you click the button called Open in Apache Zeppelin. Once I open this up, I can see my Zeppelin notebook, which is running Apache Flink behind the scenes, and I have some preloaded notebooks that we're going to interact with. First, we'll start with the MSK Data Publisher. I have put in some notes here when you're walking through this on your own, so just make sure you read these carefully. But for this demo, I'm simply going to execute these paragraphs and talk through them as I do. So this first paragraph is going to initialize our broker settings and any configuration options for publishing data into our managed streaming for Apache Kafka cluster. I'm then going to initialize a Kafka producer in Python, and I'm going to create Kafka topics, the casino events, the customer data topic, and the customer betting aggregates topic, which we'll reference later. Run this paragraph, and we can see that the topics have been created. We will execute this paragraph to define some helper methods. And then we will finally send our customer data to our Kafka topic called customer data. And lastly, we will execute this continuous loop that is going to generate casino events for the purposes of this demo and to generate some test data so we can analyze our casino events as they come through. And you can see what those events look like here. Let's navigate up to the top of this paragraph, and we will navigate back to our notebooks, where we will open up the MSK Data Analysis notebook. So this is the same deal. We are writing some instructions here, and then we are defining some tables where we will interact with our Kafka topics. So the first table we're defining is casino events, and you can see we're using the Kafka connector for Apache Flink, and we're using all of the properties that come with that Kafka connector, including the bootstrap servers, the topic, the latest offset, in the startup mode. And we also define our schema. So this schema will be saved durably in AWS Glue Data Catalog, where you can then reference it in other notebooks without needing to define it. We also define our customer data topic, customer data table, where we have our customer ID, customer name, whether or not they're an active user or a subscriber to the casino, and the date they registered. We have similar Kafka configurations defined here. And then lastly, we'll get to this at the end, but we have customer betting aggregates. This is going to be our output Kafka topic, where we are writing data to Kafka from this notebook. But nothing in particular is special here. We're just defining the same properties that we did before. So let's execute this paragraph. And those tables are dropped and recreated just for the purposes of this demo. And now we can start writing our queries. So the first query is a simple select. We're just going to grab all of the data from our customer data topic, and we can see that data appear live in real time in our notebook. And here we can see our customers, whether or not they're an active user, when they registered. It's very useful. But we may want to further filter this data to understand whether or not the customer is an active user or not. Maybe we just want to work with active users. So we could write a query where we select star from customer data where active user equals true. And if we run this paragraph, we can see that just the active users are now coming back. So with just a few added lines, we can now filter our real-time streaming data out of Kafka. But maybe we'd like to join our customer data with the casino events as they're coming in, so we can reference these and later action upon them. So this third query is select star from casino events join customer data, where the two have the same customer ID. And just for good measure, we want to make sure that they have the same active user, they're a subscriber to the casino. So here we can see the data joined together, and this looks pretty good. We could also choose to plot this data on a bar chart, see by customer ID, who's at what table. We could look at it at a pie chart. There's many different visualization options in the Zeppelin notebook. Now, this fourth query that I want to showcase is referencing what's called a tumbling window. Now, essentially a tumbling window means that we want to collect data. And in our case, we want to collect data for about 10 seconds using the processing time of our application. And in those 10 seconds, we would like to see the sum of all the transactions that are happening in our gaming tables. And the reason for this is we'd like to make sure that if a table needs a refill on chips, if they're giving a lot of money away, we want to be able to restore those chips to that table in real time. So once this paragraph runs, we'll see any tables that need a refill on chips. And so there we can see a few tables that have given away more than $2,000. All right, query five, I would like to point out that anytime you want to read through, there's very detailed notes in this notebook that will be made available after this presentation. But this is essentially pattern matching. And what you can do with the match recognize clause within Flink SQL is you can define patterns, as you can see in this line, where we can look for a certain criteria to be met after a certain amount of time or within a certain interval. In this case, we are looking for a pattern of 5 consecutive gaming events where the customer has won money. And of course, I think I'm a pretty good blackjack player, but if I were to win 5 hands in a row, it might raise some eyebrows. So let's just check if anyone is getting extremely lucky tonight with regards to the gaming events, and if the casino might want to investigate further. Okay, and after a few seconds, we can see that customer ID 29 has won 5 hands in a row. The max winning hand was $872. We see some others coming in. So these are people who are creating anomalies for our casino, and we might want to investigate a little further of what's going on. So this last query that I'm going to showcase is how you can insert data into that customer betting aggregates topic that I defined earlier. So it's basically the same query that we were writing before, using all of the tumbling windows and events that we were looking at before. And I'm just adding an insert into the customer betting aggregates table that we defined before. So once I do this, we won't see any output, but what we can be sure of is that this data is actively being written to our Kafka topic called customer betting aggregates. And we can validate that by writing another select statement off of our table called customer betting aggregates, which is actually selecting data from that topic that we're writing to. And now we can see that we've been successfully writing data to our output Kafka topic. If all that seemed interesting to you, we encourage you to try out the workshop today. If you enter in the link on your screen right now, you'll be taken to the fully self-managed workshop that you can walk through on your own in order to try out all of the things that I showcased today. Hope you enjoyed this presentation. I'm Jeremy Burr, and we look forward to hearing from you. Thank you.